Time for a Vet Minute with Revival's Director of Veterinary Services, Dr. Marty Greer. Dr. Greer, the question is about alopecia in dogs. What are the symptoms, the causes, and what types of treatments are available?
Wow, this is a huge question. So alopecia, for starters, means hair loss. So it can happen for lots and lots of reasons. Obviously, if the dog is shaved for a surgical procedure or a catheter, that's alopecia technically, but most of the time we have a pretty good answer for that. So symptoms are going to be associated with the alopecia or the hair loss will be scratching, itching, licking, biting. Sometimes there's scabs, sometimes there's sores. Sometimes it's just a quiet looking area where the hair is missing. So there's a lot of different assortments of how this can happen. There's hormonal diseases such as thyroid disease and Cushing's disease that can cause significant hair loss. Typically, those are symmetrical, not just in one spot, but if the right side has it, the left side has it too. It can be due to allergies. We see a lot of allergies in dogs, especially in the summertime. We can see pollen and mold allergies, but we can see food allergies, flea allergies, a variety of different reasons for dogs to react allergically to something. So we'll see a hair loss associated with some of those. We can see staph infections, which can happen from anything that breaks the skin, an insect bite, or it can be secondary to allergies. So anytime that there's a break in the skin and a bacterial infection develops, that's a staph infection. Staph is a normal bacteria to see on the skin of dogs and cats, but when they develop an infection, the number of bacteria in that area becomes tenfold the amount that it was before. So then you'll frequently see a rash associated with that. We can see mites. So we can see a variety of different kinds of skin mites. We can see Chylidiella, which is walking dandruff. We can see Demodex, which is a genetic disorder. We can see scabies mites, which are contagious. So there's a variety of different mites as well. The problem is, without a diagnosis, we can't really give you a treatment. We can't just say, here's a shampoo, or here's an antibiotic, or here's a steroid, or here's another allergy medication. We've got Atopica and Cytopoint and Apoquil. We've got a lot of great medications, but the first thing you need to have is a diagnosis. So we make sure that we're on the right medication, that you're not spending your money on something that's not appropriate, and that your pet isn't being subjected to medications that's not the right thing for their condition. So you're probably going to need to either do a telephone consult with a video with your veterinarian so they can see the lesions, or an in-person visit so that you can get the appropriate shampoo and oral medications or injectable medications to manage that disease.
Hi, if you're watching on YouTube, consider subscribing to the Revival Animal Health YouTube channel. If you have a pet health question, call our pet care pros at this number. And don't miss our other pet health videos.